हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू ग्लोबल ऑनलाइन यूनिवर्सिटी। फ्रेंड्स, इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस सम इंपॉर्टेंट एमसीक्यूज ऑन स्टैटिस्टिकल इकोनॉमिक्स फॉर योर अपकमिंग यूजीसी नेट एंड अदर स्टेट सेट इन इकोनॉमिक्स। फ्रेंड्स, इफ यू आर प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर यूजीसी नेट एंड अदर स्टेट सेट इन इकोनॉमिक्स, देन दिस क्रैश कोर्स इज वेरी हेल्पफुल फॉर यू। इन दिस क्रैश कोर्स वी आर गोइंग टू प्रोवाइड यू 20 मॉक टेस्ट ऑन पेपर टू इकोनॉमिक्स, एंड विद दिस 20 मॉक टेस्ट वी आर ऑल्सो प्रोवाइडिंग यू नोट्स ऑन ऑल द यूनिट्स, एंड आफ्टर अटेंडिंग द टेस्ट यू विल कम टू नो यूर score, and also will provide you solution PDF of all the 20 tests. With this we are providing you 2000 plus MCQs PDF which include all the previous year questions. Then this crash course is available only at ₹999. If you want to join, you can contact this number. You can just send a WhatsApp message, or you can also call and ask your doubts. And friends, this is the schedule of our 20 mock test. The first test will be on 20th August, second test will be on 21st August. In this way, daily we are having one test. Our last test will be on 8th September 2021. So morning at 9 PM, we will send you the test link, and evening we will send you the solution PDF. And friends, you can register on Global Online University app, and also you can directly register on WhatsApp group. So friends, let us move to the questions. Here the first question is, skewness measures regression. Yes, skewness is going to measure the regression. No doubt, skewness will measure the regression. It is correct. Then reason is, kurtosis measures flatness at the top of frequency curve. Yes, kurtosis is going to measure flatness at the top of the frequency curve. Yes, here the options are option A, both assertion and reason are true, and reason is the correct explanation of assertion. Option B, both assertion and reason are true, reason is not the correct explanation of assertion. Option C, assertion is true but reason is false. Assertion is false, reason is true. Yes, here reason is false. Here kurtosis measures flatness at the top of frequency curve. This statement is wrong here, but assertion is correct, because you can here skewness, it is a measure of symmetry. Yes, skewness is going to measure the symmetry, or more precisely the lack of symmetry. Yes, a distribution or data set is symmetric if it looks the same to the left and right. For example, bell shaped curve. Okay, it is known as the symmetric distribution, and skewness is going to measure the lack of symmetry or regression. So option A, assertion is correct here. And kurtosis, it is a measure of whether the data are heavily tailed or light tailed. So here statement, kurtosis measures flatness at the top of frequency curve, this statement is wrong here. So option C is the correct answer, that is A is true but R is false. Yes, the next question is, both regression coefficients cannot be, option A less than 1, option B greater than 1, option C equal to 1, option D none of these. Yes, here the right answer is greater than 1, because the value of the coefficient of correlation cannot exceed unity. Please remember, cannot be greater than 1. And if one of the regression coefficient is greater than unity, the other must be less than unity, but they cannot exceed, even both cannot exceed unity. So if one is greater than unity, the other will be less than unity. So both regression coefficients cannot exceed unity, so they cannot be greater than 1. The next question is, if both the regression coefficients are negative, the correlation coefficient would be negative, positive, 0, none of this. Yes, here both the regression coefficients are negative. Yes, in our last video also we have discussed, yes, negative correlation coefficient, then the correlation coefficient will be negative, perfectly negative correlation. So option A, negative, is the right answer. Yes, here you can see perfect positive correlation, perfect negative correlation. Perfect positive correlation, if the values of both the variables move in the same direction with a fixed proportion, is called perfect positive correlation, and it is indicated by the plus 1. This is the diagram for positive correlation. All the points will come on upward sloping straight line. In case of perfect negative correlation, The values of both variables move in the opposite directions with a fixed proportion, and it is indicated by minus 1. All the points will come on the downward sloping straight line. So here, if both regression coefficient are negative, the correlation coefficient will be negative. Option A is the right answer. The next question is, the under root of two coefficients gives us the value of correlation coefficient. Yes, the under root of two coefficient gives us the value of correlation coefficient. Option A, regression. Option B, SE. Option D, standard deviation. Option D, none of the above. Yes, under root of two coefficient gives us the value of correlation coefficient. It is known as the regression. Option A, regression is the right answer. The next question is, the regression lines cut each other at the point of. Yes, where the regression lines are cutting each other. Option A, average of x on y. Option B, average of x only. Option C, average of y only. Option D, none of these. Yes, the regression lines cut each other at the point average of x and y. Please remember, at the point average of x and y. Yes, here you can go through the explanation. The regression lines cut each other at the point of average of x and y. Yes, please remember it. Average of x and y. This means from the point where both the curves are intersecting, from there we will draw a perpendicular line to x-axis. We'll get the value of x. Similarly, if we draw the horizontal line, then we will get the value of y. So here just remember, the regression lines cut each other at the point of average of x and y. Yes, the next question is, if one regression coefficient is greater than 1, then the other will be. Yes, I think we have discussed in our one of questions. If one regression coefficient is greater than 1, other will be option A, less than 1, option B, more than 1, option C, equal to 1, option D, none of the above. Yes, we know that both the regression coefficients cannot exceed unity. Both cannot be greater than 1. So we can eliminate option B. So if one regression coefficient is greater than 1, other should be less than 1. So option A is the right answer. Yes, both the regression coefficient bxy and byx must have the same sign. Please remember this also. Both must have same sign. If one of them is positive, other should also positive. If one of them is negative, the other should be negative. But if one regression coefficient is greater than 1, then the other coefficient should be less than 1. Yes, if one regression coefficient is exceeding 1, other must less than unity. The next question is, the farther the two regression lines cut each other. Yes, the farther of the two regression lines cut each other. Option A, the greater will be the degree of correlation. Option B, the lesser will be the degree of correlation. Option C, does not really matter. Option D, none of the above. Yes, here you can go through the explanation. The further the two regression lines from each other, the lesser is the degree of correlation. Yes, please remember it. The further the two regression lines from each other, lesser is the degree of correlation. And the nearer the regression lines it is showing, higher the degree of correlation. Yes, please remember it. The further the two regression line, lesser the degree of correlation, and the nearer the two regression line, it shows higher the degree of correlation. So here, further the two regression lines cut each other, it shows lesser will be the degree of correlation. So option B is the right answer. The next question is assertion and reasoning question. Assertion is, in a bell-shaped distributive curve, the value of mean, median and mode would be identical. Yes, bell shaped. Yes, we know that in bell shaped, the mean, median, mode are equal. It is correct. There is no skewness in this series. Yes, mean, median, mode are equal, but equal means there is no skewness. So here, option is the right answer. Both assertion and reason are true, and reason is correct explanation of the assertion. I think this question is repeated. Sorry. The next question is, the purpose of simple linear regression analysis is to. Option A, predict one variable from another variable. Option B, replace points on a scatter diagram by straight line. Option C, measure the degree to which two variables are linearly associated. Option D, obtain the expected value of the independent random variable for a given value of the dependent variable. Yes, if you go through the explanation, you will come to know the answer here. Yes, the regression model gives the relation between two or more variables. Please remember it. Regression model is going to show the relationship between two or more variables. And the linear regression model gives the relations between two or more variables by using the straight line. Yes, please remember it. In a linear regression model, we are going to use straight line. And using the linear regression analysis, we can estimate the value of one variable using the another variables. Means it is showing the relation between two variables. What is the effect of one variable on the another variable? So here the right answer is option A. The purpose of simple linear regression analysis is option A. Predict one variable from the another variable. Option A is the right answer. The next question is, in regression analysis, if observed cost value is 50 and predicted cost value is 7, then disturbance term will be option A 53, option B 37, option C 43, option D none of the above. Yes, friends, very easy question it is. Just you know, you need to know the formula. Yes, the disturbance term, how to find the disturbance term? Disturbance term is equal to observed value minus predicted value. Just remember, disturbance term is equal to observed value minus predicted value. That is 50 minus 7. Yes, here given the observed value is 50, predicted value is 7. So the disturbance term is equal to observed value minus predicted value. Observed value is 50, predicted value is 7. So the answer will be 43. In this way, sometimes very easy questions will come, but if you don't know the formula, then you feel very difficult to answer it. Yes, then the next question is, the independent variable in a regression line is option A non-random variable, option B random variable, option C qualitative variable, option D none of the above. Yes, the let us see here, a linear regression line has an equation of y is equal to a plus bx. Yes, this is the regression line, you know it, y is equal to a plus bx. And here you know that y is called dependent variable. Yes, y is dependent variable and x is independent variable. Please remember, y is dependent variable, x is independent variable. And here a is the y intercept and b is the slope of the line. Yes, a is the y intercept and b shows the slope of the line. Yes, and the independent variable is non-random variable. Please remember, B is the independent variable, that is X is non-random variable. The non-random variable don't admit a probability measure. Yes, please remember, in this Y is equal to A plus BX, it is a regression line. Here Y is dependent variable, X is independent variable, and A is the intercept of Y. B shows the slope of the line. And here the independent variable, that is X, will be non-random variable. So here independent variable in a regression line is non-random variable. Option A is the correct answer. The next question is, the sum of the difference between the actual values of Y and its values obtained from the pitted regression line is always. Yes. The sum of the difference between the actual values of Y and its values obtained from the pitted regression line is always option A 0, option B positive, option C negative, option D minimum. Yes, just remember the answer here. The answer will be 0. The sum of difference between the actual values of Y and its values obtained from the pitted regression is 0. Yes, friend, this is about our today's session. Once again, I would like to remind you about our NATSET crash course in economics, where you will get 20 mock tests for paper 2 economics preparation. You will also get solution PDF. We are providing notes on all the units, 2000 plus MCQs PDF you will get only at ₹999. You can contact this number to join. In the same way, for paper 2 commerce also, वी आर प्रोवाइडिंग 20 मॉक टेस्ट विथ PDF सोल्यूशन प्लस नोट्स ऑन ऑल यूनिट्स एंड ऑल्सो वीडियो लेक्चर्स थ्रू MCQs ओनली एट ₹999. इफ यू वॉन्ट टू जॉइन यू कैन कॉन्टेक्ट दिस गिवन नंबर एंड इन द सेम वे फॉर पेपर वन ऑल्सो यस UGC नेट पेपर वन ऑल्सो वी आर प्रोवाइडिंग यू 60 मॉक टेस्ट फॉर पेपर वन प्रिपरेशन PDF सोल्यूशन विल बी सेंड टू यू एंड वी आर ऑल्सो गिविंग नोट्स ऑन ऑल द यूनिट्स then video lectures through MCQs and also we are giving 1000 MCQs PDF to boost your preparation level. This is also available only at ₹1000. So if you want to join, you can contact this number. You can just send a WhatsApp message or you can call and ask. So I wish all the best to all aspirants. Thank you.